Good morning, everyone. Happy New Year and welcome to another very interesting webinar from the FIT4RRI project, focus on use cases for institutional change towards responsible research and open science, the second part. I'm Adrian Solomon, part of the Southeast European Research Center from Thessaloniki, Greece, and member of the FIT4RRI project. And together with me, following my introductory words, we will have Andrea Riccio, the FIT4RRI coordinator from the University of Rome La Sapienza, and Nancy Pontica from the Open University United Kingdom. Both of them will present to us two very interesting cases from this project. The entire discussion of the FIT4RRI project, and of course this webinar series, is that science and technology can create risks and ethical dilemmas, but RRI seeks to bring research and innovation into the open, meaning to anticipate consequences and to involve society. To this end, the societal actors, such as researchers, citizens, policymakers, businesses, must work together during the research and innovation process to better align processes and outcomes with values and needs and expectations of the society, of course. And this means the involvement of all the stakeholders at all levels to minimize the potential negative impact of research and innovations on all the actions that are happening. And this is what exactly the FIT4RRI project was doing over the past 3 years. So the project identifies a serious gap between the potential role and the actual limited impact of RRI and open science on RFPOs. So together, 12 partners from 9 countries over the past 3 years, we tried to work together to solve this challenge. And now that we are towards the end of our efforts, we are doing these webinars in order to showcase to the entire community all the great outcomes of this synergy. So the objectives of the project itself were built upon two key factors, meaning training and governance, in order to achieve these specific objectives and goals. And the overall approach was basically structured around 3 stands of understanding, with the analysis, of course, testing and observation, and promotion and knowledge sharing activities in order to properly disseminate to the entire community all the key outcomes, from which part of them you will see today during the 2 case studies. Of course, we have a wide amount of resources, open access resources available to the entire community, such as, for example, the outcomes from the mapping and benchmarking, the sectoral analysis, the webinars that you can find online, and we are more than happy to provide you with all the links and with all the resources required to help you in your work, and of course, to help your entire stakeholder group to properly embed RRI and open science in your R&D process. And even more, we have a very wide base of training materials that are conveniently hosted on the FOSTER Open Science platform, which, as you may know, is the most important repository for such trainings. And most of the RRI projects from SWAFs are actually using this Open Science platform to store, in an open access manner, of course, all their related training tools. And we are, again, more than happy to provide you with more details and specific instructions of how to use it and of how to identify the actual resources that you need. And specifically for this access to knowledge, I would like to mention that in this platform, you can also see the upcoming events that are happening in the project. And partly, a very important event that you can see here is the final project conference of the FIT4RRI project that will take place in March in Rome. And we will provide throughout this webinar more details in order for you, in case you're interested to attend, of course, feel free. So going into the core of the webinar, a major part of the FIT4RRI project was the organization and implementation of RRI and open science experiments. Specifically, what we understood in this project through these experiments was an actual testing and exploration of a quadruple helix approach that would allow the embedment of RRI and open science into organizations. And we had a very wide and well-balanced variety of such experiments, you know, ranging from working with industries that would shape from a bottom-up approach an entire R&D department based on RRI, to decentralize universities like the Open University that try to embed RRI going into even more centralized and more old school, let's put it this way, universities such as La Sapienza from Rome that are trying to innovate through very innovative spin-off centers from the university and University of Liverpool that literally aimed to infuse the RRI and open science into the depth and to all the higher management levels of the university. And all these experiments were a true success. And the way we adopted our approach towards their implementation, of course, because we aimed at being consistent and providing a good value for monitoring and comparison at the end of the day towards ensuring that the experiments achieved their goals, is that all experiments followed a standardized methodology that was developed as part of the project. You can see it here on the slides in a nutshell, this graphical representation. So what happened here is that we had various stages of multi-stakeholder engagement, quadruple helix engagement in this specific case, starting from the appraisal, design, implementation, follow-up and observation, and an overall mutual learning stage. Specifically, what was happening here is that while trying to embed the quadruple helix into the decision-making factors for stabilizing and infusing the organizations with the RRI and open science concept, there were various barriers that institutions were facing, and such barriers even started from the not knowing what are the actual quadruple helix actors involved to the actual participatory engagement strategy. Why would they be involved in RRI and open science activities? Why do they actually care about this? Do they get any benefits? So it was indeed a true challenge and a true synergy that was required to properly ensure that all these four experiments that we had in the project embedded RRI through a quadruple helix approach, because otherwise we cannot actually talk about RRI and open science.